I'm the application engineer. Basically, I have done my geophysics from Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra, master's, and then after I'm basically registered for the PhD in the same domain. Today, basically, the contents will be about us, basically what our company delivers in both academic and commercial domain, what are the products range for various applications. Then we will start discussing about the background of GPR, because it is very important to know a little bit what are the terminologies and what are the factors while going into the GPR prospecting. And then we will be discussing a little bit about the application domains, because GPR is basically for the near surface geophysics domain, exploring the near surface geology. It can actually look into anything unless it is metal, basically. So applications are limitless, and it is the only geophysical tool basically serving for the maximum number of application in current scenario. Then we will be discussing a little bit about some of the examples that I have set for this introductory presentation, and then of course we will be taking the away sessions for discussion. So about the rotor precision instruments, basically is a part of Rotor Group of company with a legacy of 85 years. So we've been serving in Indian market basically the ground penetrating radar scanner, whether it is terrestrial or mobile, from Teledyne Optech, and then of course the airborne LiDAR from Yellowscan, and photogrammetry LiDAR and surveillance drones from Quantum System Germany. So we are the pan India distributor come partner of the of these brands. Basically today we will be focusing only on the GPR, the ground penetrating radar, from sensors and software. So a little bit about the sensors and software. Since 1988, it's been distributing its instrument all over the globe for almost like 100 countries, and it is one of the pioneer in the GPR technology, having various application domains consisting of various GPR units. Basically for concrete we have Conquest, and of course the whenever GPR comes, everybody can think of the utility mapping for a mapping of the urban and rural region, basically for the underground utilities. LMX series is there, and then comes if you want to have a density profile, a continuous density profile of the pavements of road, and we want to inspect any sort of hazard scenario if it is going to be occurring in near future. Then comes the finder for forensic investigation, like if some investigation agency like CBI or someone wants to find a buried body or buried cache of drugs, or wants to investigate like what are the patterns in doing some crime. Then comes the ice map, basically used for the mapping of ice, usually in the northern regions. Basically one of the application one can think, like, why are we going to use GPR for mapping the ice? It's basically to investigate, like for example, like in cold days in northern regions, our Indian Army has to deploy a lot of utilities in those remote areas, and due to the ice cap on the roads, basically it's impossible to do that, and to basically scratch out all that ice map, we need to have its thickness so that we don't destruct the road at the time of excavation. And then comes the snow scan, basically a fresh snow for the skiing purposes. We need to have some estimate, like what is the fresh snow in the region, so that any hazard like avalanche or something like these things can be scaled on a map and take the actions accordingly. So basically I would like to discuss more about these two units, basically pulse echo and knocking, because these two units are the focus unit for all the application according to the choice of sensor that you want to have in them. So one is PulseEcho, another is Noggin, covering almost from concrete scans to the geological scan or glaciology scans. So the only difference basically they have only is the one is monostatic and one is bistatic. I will be discussing what is monostatic GPR and bistatic GPR later on. And then comes the rescue radar. Basically, if you want to find some survivor in buried in some debris, for example, avalanche or any breakage of any building and some people are there to be rescued, then you can use this particular instrument. The technology has gone so far, like you can actually detect the heartbeat using this particular instrument of the survivors, and you can rescue the alive persons first and then you can go for the bodies. Echo Project basically is the software tool, a group of software tools basically that can be utilized with any of these units. So this was a little bit about the product range that basically Sensors and Software offers here in Indian market for different applications. So let's move forward to the GPR prospecting, like what is GPR and how it works. A lot of questions are there. Some of my colleagues from the geophysics domain may have heard of it as well as in the geology, or like as I have already mentioned, a lot of applications are there, so somebody must have heard of it. With, like if anyone is interested, then definitely can contact us.